Hi, hello, namaskara. In this new topic, we'll be discussing more about magnetostatics fields, and this is a brief introduction video about the whole course that I'll be taking up in the further times to come. So let's hop on and see what are the things that we'll be seeing in this whole unit 3. To sum up with, basically I'll be having my things laid out. So firstly, I'll be giving you outline, wherein in the outline the syllabus can be divided into, like, the unit 3 can be divided into part 1 and part 2, wherein in part 1 I'll be speaking about magnetostatics fields. Okay, it is more about the fields, and we'll be understanding the concept of the fields of magnetism. The part 2 is where I'll be speaking about the magnetic forces. Okay, so the things that I will be covering in part 1 is basically, it will be few laws, the laws which you already or you would have come across in your plus 2 or plus 1 or 10th. So those are Biot-Savart's law, Ampere-Circuiton law and its application. We'll be seeing magnetic flux density. It is very much related to the electrostatics part, where in electrostatics part we had discussed about electric field intensity, electric flux density. In a similar way, we will be discussing about magnetic flux density, magnetic fields and all, and we'll be talking about the curl operator here, where if you remember in electrostatics we had discussed about the divergence operator or divergence, okay, del operator. Similarly, we'll be speaking about the curl operator here. If you recall, divergence was a dot product, where curl is a cross product. Okay, just we'll understand curl in the later section. Then we'll be discussing the Stokes theorem, and finally we'll be coming to the main fundamentals of electromagnetics, that is the Maxwell's equations for a static field. So we'll be discussing that. At the end, we'll be speaking about a bit of magnetic scalar and vector potentials. So this is what we have planned to cover in part 1. Part 1 will not be covered up in one video, but part 1 will be eventually covered up in multiple video series. Okay. Coming to part 2. In part 2, we'll be speaking about magnetic forces. So what are the things that we'll be dealing is forces due to the different magnetic fields. What is magnetic torque and what is its momentum? How a magnetic dipole, or what is the concept of the magnetic dipole? Then the boundary conditions of magnetisms. So in the last section, or in the unit 2, if you remember, we have discussed about the boundary conditions with respect to electric field intensity and electric flux density. So that was in electrostatics. So here we'll be speaking in terms of magnetostatics. Okay, and at last, magnetic energy. This is what we have to cover up in this unit 3. So why have to study all these things? Basically, you have to understand the effect of charge. In the unit 1 and unit 2 of our electromagnetics subject, you have studied the concept of electrostatics, or the behavior of charge in a static condition. Now what we are going to do is, I have a charge, instead of keeping it stationary, I am going to push it, so it will move with some constant velocity. So when it moves through some constant velocity, I have a magnetic field that is created around that particular charge which is moving. So I am going to find, or I am going to explain, or I am going to understand the effects of charge under motion. So it is not now a static electric charge, it is a charge which is moving. Okay, so but it is moving at a constant velocity. So due to that velocity of movement, a constant velocity of movement, I have a magnetostatic field that is generated around it. So we'll be seeing that, and we'll be seeing different applications in different domains that we have. So to end up, how we'll do that? So we'll be achieving like this every day or every video lecture that I'll be sharing up with you from now onwards. I'll be trying to cover each and every important concepts that I just discussed in the outline, and I'll be trying to solve few numerical problems again. I'll be making some lectures on the problem, how to solve the problem, and to assess you, I'll be having few quizzes and assessments after every set of videos. Okay, so this is what we have planned to cover. So this is what I'll be doing. So this whole thing is what has been planned for the next 2 weeks. Thank you.